In this video, I'm going to introduce you all to Movavi Photo Editor 2024. Okay, you can see this is my Windows desktop here. I'm going to click the icon, Movavi Photo Editor 2024. Perfect, program is opening now. Okay, we have all the standard Windows options. Let's click settings. Language is English. Preferences, let's click that. Okay, automatically check for updates, I leave that checked. Save extended logs for troubleshooting was unchecked. Send anonymous data to Movavi about the program work, that's checked, I leave that checked. And of course, interface language is English. Files, you can see the temporary folder. And show last edited file on the start page, I leave that checked. When you close your program and open it again, your last edited file will be on the start page here. So now I'm just going to cancel out of that, and now I'm going to open a picture. Okay, this is me here. Perfect, that looks great. You can see the photograph is awesome. I'm not awesome necessarily, but it's a great picture. I took that with my cell phone. Now let's click open. I'll show you another trick. Click the desktop. I'm going to drag the sample pics folder over to this workspace here. Copy, I'm just going to place it down here, and now click open. Now you can see all our pictures open. Every picture in that folder is now open, all 19. Perfect. If I wanted to delete them all, I could just click the bin here. Although I'll tell you, always make sure you have your photographs backed up into another folder or another storage media. Don't forget to back up all your pictures. Now we can go through this now. We can adjust automatically or manually. You can do it yourself, or you can do some automatic presets. You have all kinds of stuff here. Favorites, custom, AI magic, classic, colored. We can see all this stuff up here. We have the selection brush, magic wand tool, lasso tool, polygonal lasso, and the rectangular marquee tool. And the selection eraser, lots of great stuff here. You have erasing tools, erasing objects here, pardon me, around the left. We have the background change, which is really cool. I can't wait to make another video about that for y'all at a later time, pardon me. Old folder restoration, retouching, all kinds of great stuff here. Effects, we have lots of effects here, the popular favorites, vignettes, textures, artistic retro disco, creative. You can see it's defaulted to popular. I'm just going to click creative and we can try one of these. I'm going to try the Elvis here. That's great. Looks great. It's pretty neat. Now I'm just going to click undo for the time being. There's our captions to add text to the photo. And this is picture in picture. We can place another picture on the photograph here. And of course, we can resize. We can see this photograph is 1944 by 2592. It's the original aspect ratio. Now let's click the About button. The About tab here, pardon me. Photo Editor 2024. That's great. Okay. We can click File and get the file information here. File info. See a lot of great stuff there. Motorola. Was the camera manufacturer, camera model, Model E. Now we can see the shutter speed, the F number, the ISO, the flash mode. Format was JPEG. Click OK. Perfect. And about, we can always check for updates, but we can, as I showed you earlier in the preferences, we can leave that checked and get the automatic updates. However, if you're not always connected to the internet, you can do that. You can, if you're not always connected to the internet, you can just click about and check for updates. Now let's try the background change. I'm just going to show you. Now I'm going to click automatically. Isn't that great? That's awesome. That's pretty cool. I'll be doing another video on that in the future. And we can stick with, we can add a photo to be the background, or we can pick from the presets here. Like for example, let's try this one. That is really awesome. Look. Or we could use a color. You have a selection of colors. We can, and or we can edit the picture a little bit here. We can erase. You have the eraser tool. So a lot of great features in this program that I'll be discussing with you in future videos. Okay, this is a great program. I think it's going to be awesome. Thank you very much for watching.